Good morning, children. So we are continuing with the reported speech and we are taking up interrogative sentences today. Now the first question that comes to our mind, the very first question that comes to our mind is, what are the methods of changing direct into indirect? We shall be discussing about the methodology. Well, first of all, you must understand that there will be certain rules in changing direct into indirect of interrogative sentences. Here, said to will be changed into asked. In the general sentences or in the simple sentences, said to was changed into told, but here in interrogative sentences, said to will be changed into asked. Then, you know, this sentence, that will be a question. The sentence which is in interrogative form, will be transformed into, you know, assertive form using the structure subject plus verb plus object plus complement. This will be the a form of the sentence of assertive form. Subject plus verb plus object plus complement. That means interrogative statement will change into assertive statement. Question will be replaced by full stop. So what are the changes? Change number one, said to will be changed into asked. The sentence which is in interrogative form will be written or transformed into assertive form using the formula subject plus verb plus object plus complement. Question will be replaced by, you know, full stop. Then we will execute, there will be execution of, execute change of tense and change of person. Execute change of tense and change of person as per rule. Last but not the least, if the question is yes or no type, jis question ka answer yes ya no mein ho, then the conjunction if or whether will be added. What will be added? If or whether. See, if the question is of yes or no type, the conjunction if or whether will be added. And last, execute the elementary change like this, that, today, that day, tomorrow, the next day, like that. Now then, execute the elementary changes along with change of person that we will be discussing in examples. So what are the methods of changing interrogative sentences from direct into indirect? First of all, we will replace said to by asked. In all conditions, said to will be replaced by asked or inquired of. We generally use asked. Then if the sentence always is in question form, that will be transformed into assertive form with the formula subject plus verb plus object plus complement. Then we will execute change of tense and change of person as per the rule. If the question is of yes or no type, the conjunction if or whether will be added, WHETHER, whether will be added. And at last, we will execute elementary changes. Elementary changes will be executed at last. Let us see how it happens. One example. We are taking one example. Example number one. He said to me, yeah, comma, inverted comma starts. Do you know me? Yes. Look at that. Now, in this part, this is the reporting verb, said to. And that I said, it will be changed into asked. So, it will become, he asked me. And as it is, you know, in the form of question, and that is yes, no type question, because the answer of this question, do you know me, will be either yes or no. Therefore, the conjunction if or whether will be added. I am adding if. Now, the statement, the question is, do you know me? First of all, let us change this question into assertive. So, according to that, it will be, do will be replaced. You know me will become assertive form, and we will remove the question mark. Now, you is who? Change the person. Now, the speaker is he, and the addressee is me. So here, the you, me is you. That is, first person is here, second person. So, second person will change according to, change the person into first person. So, here it will be I, if I. You will become I, and no, past tense of no is new. If I knew, and me, who is me here? Here the first person is the speaker. Here the first person, you know, he said to me, he is the speaker. So the here me is for the third person. So first person will change into third person. If I knew him, me will change into him. So what are the changes? Let us see. Said to has been changed into asked. The conjunction if has been added. Then here you know me, that in assertive form, do you know me, do hat gaya, you know me ban gaya. You is second person will change into first person according to the change of person rule. Here the addressee is first person, so the second person will change into the first person according to the addressee. And no will become new, because past tense of no is new, if I knew. And me will change into him, because here the speaker is third person, he. So the first person will change into third person. So these are the changes. Second example we'll take, it will be more clear. He said to him, what are you doing now? But this is another type. Let us take that one. He said to him, did you intend to come with me? He said to him, did you intend to come with me? Question mark. Now, first of all, let us, you know, transform did you intend to come with me into assertive form by using the formula S plus V plus O plus C. So here subject is you, so it will become you, and did will be removed, then it will become intended, V2, intended. You intended to come with me. Now, full stop, question mark has been removed. But who is you here? Here, this speaker is third person, he, and he is speaking to the third person only, him. So, you will become he. Intended is simple past tense. So, it will become past perfect. He had intended to come with me. Me, the first person is here, third person, with him. So, now, he asked him if he had intended, past perfect, if he had intended to come with him. Now, what are the changes that I have made? Here, said to has been changed into asked. The conjunction if or whether has been added. Now, here, intended is the simple past. So, simple past changed into past perfect. So, if he had intended to come with him. Here, we are making change of tense also, change of person also. Now, so far as change of tense is concerned, these are the change of tenses. Simple present always changes into simple past. Simple past. I'll give one example. Simple present changes into simple past. Simple present is subject plus V1/V5. Plus object plus complement. This will change into subject plus V2 plus object plus complement. One example I am giving. She said to me, comma, do you know MS? Do you know MS? Question mark. So here set will change into ask. She asked me if I, past tense of know is new, simple past is new, if I knew English. So know will become V2, that is new. This is simple present. In simple present, verb is know, and in simple past, it is new. If I knew English. One more example of that is present continuous changes into past continuous. Present continuous changes into past continuous. One example I am taking, past continuous. The teacher said to the boy, are you coming to the hall now? Now, here, first of all, you change this into a statement. Are you coming to the hall now? Will change into you are coming to the hall now. And who is you? The boy. So it will become he. And are will change into actually were. But here it is he is there. So it will be was. He was coming to the hall now.